Guys, welcome back to another episode of the pet series. So today what we're going to be working on is modeling, and I have decided I probably don't want to go exactly the same with a real life animal. So what I'm going to do is change it up a little bit. We're going to go ahead and just go up to the file project, and then we can call this something else. When you're filling this part out, make sure that you don't fill out the class because that will mess things up. We just want to change the model identifier and the file name, which we can change by saving it. Come up with a name called Zeddy. So we'll be basically using this as the model identifier. Now remember, we need to actually have this all lowercase. So when you're filling it out, make sure that it's all lowercase and not to have any capital letters. So it should be a Zeddy with a lowercase z. We're going to confirm, and then what we're going to go and do is we're going to go ahead and save project as, and I'm going to call it, we can just call it Zeddy, lowercase, like we did with the model identifier, and we'll save that. We should be good to go. I'm just going to double check to make sure that it's on my desktop. Yep, it should update the name in the profile thing for the workspace tab right here. So it should say Zeddy now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just create a bone, which is a folder basically. What this is going to do is it's always going to be in the center here. That's fine for the moment. When you add a folder like this, this is going to be where the animations are going to be happening. So anything in these cubes here, you'll be able to animate them. When you're creating a bone, you want things like for the arms, legs, maybe even the body parts like the chest and head, definitely the head. So those are the main core things that you would be animating. Some things maybe like tails or ears, maybe even for them to kind of flicker or something like that when on like a horse or something. So all those would probably require different bones, which you would then go into the animate tab and then set your animations up. The only thing that you need to consider is each component should be in its own little group here. So for example, these leg parts for that leg should be in its own bone for that. And then for the other legs, they're in their own bones as well. As you can see, we've selected a few of them, and there's four legs. We have a body bone for this one. We got our head below that, so that's our head like type thing, and then we got a tail type thing back here. What we need to do now is name all these things unique names so that they will not have conflict with each other. This includes the bones themselves and the cubes, so we'll need to come up with some proper names for that. So we have left leg, so this is identifier is LF, which is left front. You can name it whatever you like that makes it easier for you. For this, I'm just calling it abbreviation, so it's a little bit easier for me to understand and stuff. The cube names aren't really going to matter too much. When we go into animation and stuff like that, we'll be working with the folders for the bones themselves, so we'll be animating those instead. So all these different parts will basically be animated. So when you're looking at a model like this, what you want to consider is where things are actually going to be rotating around, right? So if we select this leg here, our center point is in the middle right now for the bone. We want to make sure that it's actually going to rotate correctly. So a quick test of the rotation, we can see that it's not going to do what it would normally do when we're rotating around. So if we wanted to go back or forth or whatever, that's not going to really work because it's rotating around the center of the entity, not the bone itself, or where it should be. It should be somewhere around the face of the purple block. As you can see, if we're like trying to walk or whatever, it's going to look really odd. So what we can do is we can shift this axis, like this part right here, using the pivot point. We can start with centering that, and then we can go ahead and locate that location. So it should be somewhere in the center here. And then what we can do is we can start moving that pivot point out. When you're working with pivot points, you probably want to make sure that there is no decimal point behind it, so you can try to set this to like -7, and then we'll do 8, and then we'll do -6. So that should center it mostly. Now, because it is I think 3, it will need like 6.5. What we're going to do is we're going to select that bone again. Make sure that you have the right thing selected, and we're going to put that to 0.5 just to center it because it is an odd number, so we will need to have it centered like that. And then what we can do is we can go backwards until it aligns with the the mesh here, and then we'll go up. We'll go up to about here, I think. Gonna actually bring this out a little bit more. So we're gonna bring it to there, and just need to remember I need to go back to directions. So I'm gonna have it about here, I think, for the pivot point. And then we'll go ahead and then go 1, 2 to center it again. We can see how it's rotated. So we can see that it's going to rotate around this axis now, not the axis of where it was centered to the entity. And if we start rotating things around, it'll look a little bit more natural and everything seems like it's fine. Now, just a key tip here, when you have things like connect to your body, you want to make sure that the pivot point is where the part meets. So basically in this case, the head would be somewhere in here and then the legs would be somewhere where the center of those are. The tail, it's going to be right at the base of the table right here. So I got all the cubes set up for the pivot points. We're going to just rotate these around so we can rotate them on different axes and they should rotate accordingly. I recommend checking all of them out before you move on to the next tutorial. So we're just going to basically rotate this around just so we know what we can expect when we're actually animating and stuff. So those are good. And then we have our tail. So we'll be our pivot points right here. And we'll be moving this around so we can see that this rotates those directions and we can move it up and down. So that's good. And we should be able to move it or rotate it around the side as well. So this is perfect for what we need. For the legs, they all connect where they need to. So they're all at the base here. So when we rotate the pivot points, they're going to rotate around where they need to. As you can see here, perfect. So all those are set up. So it's just right at the bottom first pixel right there on the purple mesh. So that will allow it to rotate. And same idea for the other side here. It's just flipped onto the other side. So it's right about there. And the other one's right about here. And for this one, it's right about there. And same for that one, it's right about there. So that's basically the difference. That's all we're going to do for today. Next episode, what we'll work on is the texturing and getting that all sorted out. And then we can move on to the animation and stuff. And that's when we actually get to start playing around with the actual rotations and stuff. So that'll be pretty fun. But other than that, if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, comment down below, rate the video, and let me know in the comments what you liked about it. And I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Peace out.